Hello everyone, I'm Alona and now I invite you to Summit Island. I'm going there by car, follow me. I will spend there 3 nights and show you the most interesting places in Koh Samet. Let's go. I started from Pattaya, road from Pattaya to Summit Island. The port from which boats sail to Summit Island is called Ban Pier. It is about 80 kilometers from Pattaya. There are several ways to get there. The South Royal Road Sihanouk Highway leads there, and you can also use Highway 36. We got there via Highway 36. We were driving from Chamtien, so it was suitable for us to turn to Sihanouk Highway, then turn left to Hua Yai and across a rural road, we all got to 36th road. This way the closest way to Ban Pie Pie. It took us 1.5 hours. If you will be using this road, it allows you to keep some money on a toll road. If it will be more convenient for you to use Highway 7, you'll pay 10 baht. After Highway 36, take the Sihanouk Highway and follow the signs. Navigator helps you. Maple apps allowed us to put Koh Samet in the destination line. Google Maps failed the task. The Google set up a destination Ban Pie. And here I'm at the pier. If you come here by your own or rented car without a driver, then convenient parking is provided for you. The car's parking costs 100 baht per night. You pay immediately when buying a boat ticket. If you are late, pay extra upon arrival. Keep your parking ticket until the end of the trip. Without it, you won't be released from the parking. I read several stories online about a trip here by motorbike, but I didn't see parking for motorbikes on this pier. There were no people who wanted to take a motorbike with them on board this day either. I have known about different types of vessel which sailed there. A speedboat cost 150 baht for one way. This way takes no more than 10 minutes. I didn't test this information, I saw an advertisement only. This information I have seen when I left the island. So I saw stinky slow boat then. They were colored blue and red. I didn't use them and can't tell about my experience nothing. You can buy a bus ticket in both directions at once, and the return ticket with open date. Although, I also saw a ticket office on the island. A one-way ticket for one person cost 60 baht. There and back 120 baht. Pay and wait for your boat according to the schedule. It will be useful to take a photo of the schedule for the convenience of planning a return way. The distance from the pier to the island is about 10 kilometers. Our voyage took no more than 30 minutes. Summit Island had the status of a national park. Entry to it is possible for foreigners only with payment of a special fee. The ticket costs 200 baht. There are no discounts for Thai license holders, only the full price. You can stay on the island with this ticket for any days without restriction.
Yeah.
there are no private cars on the island. Only green and white cars are taxis and hotel. The fire is from 50 baht to the near beach, up to 150 baht at the discretion of the driver. Payment is calculated per person. Essen Hotel can go as a shared bus with fellow travelers or as a taxi private. Here is agreed. Upon arrival on the island, I planned to rent a bike. The proposed price of the bike is 100 baht per hour or 400 baht per day. The hostess easily agreed to 300 baht per day when paying for 3 days. A tank of gasoline was included in the price. The distances on the island are small. We used less than half of tank. The bikes are rented old, shabby, cracking, but is going at gasoline consumption. You can drive about 30 kilometers with 1 liter. A ton of motorbikes such as Yamaha Novo, Honda Click, about 4 liters. You can buy the bottles of gasoline in the cafe along the route. I didn't see any specialized gas stations. The roads on the island are good, made of concrete. There are a lot of road signs everywhere. It's easy to navigate. But you need to drive slowly and carefully, because there are many speed limiters everywhere. The island has an uneven terrain, a lot of descents, ascents, sharp turns. But if you've been to Koh Chang, driving here will seem very easy and comfortable, even at night. And I'll also say a few words about accommodation. I rented a cheap room. My evaluation criteria were cleanliness and beachfront location. I liked several rooms through a booking.com, and I finally made a reservation when I was already sailing by ferry to the island. I paid at the hotel by Thai bank account application with QR code. My note, everywhere in Thailand, except 7-Eleven, payment is available through the application of the Thai banks. I use Siam Bank. It's easy. I recommend it. My number room cost 425 baht per night. For this money, there was a room in a separate house on the shore. The room was clean, has an own washroom, table, chairs, kettle, cups, spoons, towels, fun. And also a plastic set of furniture on the veranda. Staff brought coffee and water every day. The room was double. Who is interested in the option of cheap accommodation on the island, I will put a link in the description. There was internet in the bungalow if anyone needed. I used my DTEC card about where and how I bought it, as well as the price of the card you can see in the video on my channel. Mobile internet worked fine. The navigator was available everywhere on the island. I met foreign vacationers there. Everyone called the price of rooms with breakfast about 2,000 baht per night. I think it's a usual price for these hotels. And here I'm on the island. I will tell you the continuation of the story in my next videos. Subscribe to my channel and don't miss my new videos about this amazing place. Bye, guys.